Yes, Peter, good morning to all. We are doing this chapter in the Kingdom of Fools, and only question answers are left now. So can you rotate this book for me? You will be giving answers. First question is, what are the two strange things the guru and his disciple find in the Kingdom of Fools? Very easy and very important. Yes, Jia. So sit down. Two strange things about that kingdom that guru and disciple found. It was, they called the day, they were sleeping during the day and they were awake throughout the night. Clear? So two strange things. First is, the day was treated as night and night was being treated as day. People would open their shops at night and they would go to sleep during the day, in very simple language. Secondly, everything could be purchased at one currency only, one dadu, D-U-D-D-U, fine? So one dadu was the amount fixed for each and every object. So these two things were very strange. Why does the disciple decide to stay in the kingdom of fools? Is it a good idea? Two parts are there to this question. Yes, yes, Divya. Yes, correct answer. I will be giving chance to the students sitting at home also. Now, kindly listen to the second answer. Divya has given correct answer. The disciple decides to stay in the kingdom of fools because everything could be purchased at one dadu only. It was quite cheaper to purchase bananas, rice and ghee, etc., which he liked the most. So he decided, because he was very fond of eating also. Fine. Second paragraph mein you will be writing, no, it is not a good idea, because in the kingdom of fools, any circumstance could be there. His guru also warned him against such foolish people who are following different norms, wrong norms. Name all the people who are tried in the king's court and give the reasons for their trial. This is a big question, because you have to name all the people who were given the fault and also the reasons. Yes, Sunaisa, why are you talking, beta? Harmeet, you can answer this question loudly enough so that everyone listens. Harmeet, you can speak. I guess you're not able to unmute yourself. So let me give a student sitting here who wants to give answer. Already I discussed this yesterday only. Pratiksha, yes, speak.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, second question now.
Third question, name all the people.
Okay. The owner of the house, that is the merchant, the bricklayer, the dancing girl, and the goldsmith were tied in king's court. They all were tied because the thief did when the wall of merchant had collapsed. The merchant was tied for building a weak wall. The bricklayer was tied for doing his work carelessly. The girl was tried because of disturbing the concentration of bricklayer. The goldsmith was blamed for making the dancing girl walk up and down to the house of a dozen times.
And dancing girl gave blame to goldsmith, and goldsmith gave blame to merchant. So the blame again comes back to merchant. So you can name, this is very easy question. Fine, you can just find in the book only. Clear? Firstly, who was blamed? That merchant whose house, in whose house that wall fell, and he make the bricklayer responsible for it. Then bricklayer was called. He called the name of that dancing girl who disturbed and distracted him when he was making the wall. Then dancing girl was called. She blamed the goldsmith who was making her jewelry. And then finally that you can say goldsmith blamed the merchant, the rich merchant himself, who had given that order of in bulk of jewelry. Fine. So these are the reasons also and people also. Who is the real culprit according to the king? Why does he escape punishment? Yes, according to the king.
May I mute myself?
Yes, Tiksha, you can mute yourself, beta. Yes. Why? So finally, king decided, yes, Brijesh, right? The real culprit, according to the king, was the rich merchant only, in whose house that wall fell. And finally, goldsmith also make him responsible because he had given order of jewelry. And due to that, everything happened. So according to, and why does he escape punishment? What was the reason? Yes, yes, very good. He was too thin to fit the stake. Clear? He was too thin to fit that stake. That's why he escaped that punishment. That's it. Nothing else you will write. What are the guru's words of wisdom? Very important. What are the guru's words of wisdom and when does the disciple remember them? Yes, Jaydev, will you answer it? No? Yes, Vita, first is, you know that guru's words of wisdom, very easy. Guru said that you never, you know, trust such people, what they can do at any time. So exact words are written in your book only, Vita. It is on page number 24 or 23. Can you tell me the exact line? Yes, page number 20, very first line, underline, because we have to write exact words. So Guru's words of wisdom were, they are all fools. This won't last very long and you can't tell what they will do to you next. Page number 20, very first lines. Clear? So when does the disciple remember them? When disciple was chosen to be hanged by the king. Fine? Because disciple was very fat and he could fit the stake. He was chosen by the king. And then he remembered his guru's words that now everything is against him. How does the guru manage to save his disciple's life? Guru made a plan and he whispered in the ears of his disciple that we would be asking the king to hang us, to kill us first. And then they told the king that whosoever would be dying first will become king in the next when they take rebirth, and the person who dies second, that person will become minister. Clear? So this is the way guru managed to save the life of disciple. And king and minister, they hanged themselves in greed of becoming king and minister once again. Yes, then next it is not to be done in the notebook. Only these six questions you will be doing. Fine, what we can do is we can start the new chapter or we can do grammar. What do you want to do? New chapter? Or grammar. So we have finished this chapter, beta, in the kingdom of fools. So let's start a new chapter. At least we'll be able to get introduction. Fine, I won't be able to share the PDF because I had not downloaded yet. Okay, Titiksha and everyone in here also. So we are going to start new chapter, The Happy Prince. But kindly keep on sending your notebooks. very less number of students are sending. Yes, you can do. Yes. We are going to do chapter The Happy Prince. Very interesting. I really, you know, the way they have, if you have done even, then also you have to do this. Yes, Vita. So there are many characters. And one statue is the main character in this. So firstly, a statue. Otherwise, a statue never speaks. But a statue is the protagonist or main character. Statue of Happy Prince. Why we call him happy, we'll read in the story. The Happy Prince was actually a beautiful statue, right? And he was covered with gold, sapphires, very, you know, costly jewelry. And in his eyes, sapphires were mounted and pasted, you can say, assembled. Body was covered with gold and a ruby in his sword. He was carrying that sword, talwar uske haath mein thi, and a ruby. Ruby is again very costly, you can say, jewelry. Then, why did he want to part with all the gold that he had and his precious stones? Fine, so ruby is also one of the precious stones. So, why this Happy Prince, the statue, he was gilded with valuables, gold, ruby, sapphires, diamonds and all, but he does not want to keep all those things with him. We will be reading in this chapter only, though it is a fictional chapter. It is a fiction. What is a fiction? Which is imaginary. This is not based on some real incident. Fine, this is people start saying, okay, this is not happening, you know, how can a statue speak or how can a statue do like that? But this chapter is to teach us some moral values. Clear? So by seeing that statue, we can imbibe many values in us. What are those values? The values which we are going to learn out of this chapter or imbibe. Values are not taught to anyone. Values are caught, catch hoti hai wo. When you see your parents, your teachers, your siblings, your friends doing some work of charity, then you also, you know, try to imbibe those values. So these are imbibed. They grow within you only. You cannot catch or copy values. So value of kindness or generosity, one and same thing. Then we will learn empathy. What do you mean by empathy? When we put ourselves in the shoes of others, apne aap ko dusre ki jagah pe rakke dekhna, that what if it happens to me? What if same condition happens to me? Sympathy hota hai, just waise hi sympathize with others. Empathy is when you feel the pain of others. Fine, so we are going to learn sympathy also out of this chapter. Kindness, empathy, and very important, joy of giving. The best thing which we are going to learn from this chapter. I'm not able to adjust, but I'm going to write joy of giving. Or sharing. You might have seen a video or an ad. Joy of giving is one another value. Or sharing is caring, another thought which we catch from this chapter. Fine, sharing is caring, kindness, empathy, joy of giving. Now, before starting this chapter, let me tell you, we people have many valuables. We are blessed. We have clothing. And when you go to party, you say, you open your, again, you say drawer, you say, I don't have any new dress to wear on the party. We have so many clothes and many clothes which we never wear even. Many toys which we never played with. Fine. Many blankets which are useless lying in our beds and you can say almirahs and all. But we are not sharing with others. Fine. What is the fun of accumulating the wealth? If a person dies, will he carry any of these objects? So this statue is gilded with precious stones. Are these stones going to help this statue? When person is alive, we never ask him. When a person dies, we start, you know, making statues and all. During, you know, previous era, making statues was very common act. When a person from royal family, especially king, prince, princesses, when they would die, their statues were erected. That was part of their life. That so that people will remember even after their death. Clear? So this statue actually is going to get life. And he'll be discussing that how we should be kind towards others and how we can help others actually. Fine. High above the city on a tall column stood the statue of the happy prince. So in a city at a very high pedestal, at a very higher stage, a statue is mounted and that statue belonged to happy prince. He was gilded all over with thin leaves of fine gold, real gold. His body was covered with that. For eyes, he had two bright sapphires, that precious stones. Sapphires are very costly, even more than gold. So in his eyes were made up of sapphires. And a large red ruby glowed on his sword hilt. Sword hilt is that place from where we hold that sword. So there, that red ruby was gilded. You know, people wear rings of ruby and they just get it gilded into their jewelry and all. So it is very costly. So that was there in one of the swords which he was carrying. One night, there flew over the city a little swallow. Swallow is a bird. Fine. Here, do not think swallowing means drinking something and gulping and all. Little swallow was a bird. His friends had gone away to Egypt 6 weeks before. You might have heard about migratory birds in your sciences and all or social. Have you heard about migratory birds? Yeah. Those who migrate to, you know, when weather changes, they change their place. You just see on Discovery Channel. There are many birds. They change place when weather is too cold or too hot for them. They change their even country. Sometimes they keep on flying for days and for months to change their place. They are called migratory birds. So swallow bird is one of them. So his friends had gone away to Egypt 6 weeks before. All the friends of swallow bird. And you know, they just fly in groups only. You might have seen in the sky. All the friends had, whose friends? Birds' friends, swallow bird's friends. But he had stayed behind. Then he decided to go to Egypt too. He was staying there and then he said, okay, I will be also going to Egypt only. All day long, he flew and at night, he arrived at the city. You know, I told you already, they keep on flying. But when they got a resting place, they rest in between. So when he stopped in the city where the statue was erected, where shall I put up? Means where shall I take rest now? What should I do? I hope the town has made preparations. Means something will be there for us also. Then he saw the statue on the tall column, that highly mounted column. Say pillars hote hain. And it was a broad pillar, you can say that column. And statue was standing. You have seen it many roundabouts. City mein aapke bahut sare Bhagat Singh Chowk is there. Fine. And many others are there where statues are erected. So in that way, at higher place, I will put up there, he cried. He found this statue to be suitable place because nobody can reach there. It is a fine position with plenty of fresh air. So he alighted just between the feet of the happy prince. You can see in between the feet of happy prince there is a space. He alighted, he sat over there, and he thought, I would be staying shelter here between the feet of this statue. Clear? Any doubt to anyone? Fine. Very beautiful story this is. I have a golden bedroom, he says. ऊपर देखते हैं तो गोल्डन का है, गोल्ड का सैफायर्स एंड इतना कॉस्टली स्टैचू है. सो ही इज जस्ट स्टार्टेड सेइंग टू हिमसेल्फ दैट बर्ड दैट टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्लीप इन अ गोल्डन बेडरूम. एंड ही लुक्ड अराउंड. नेक्स्ट पेज बेटा. ही प्रिपेयर्ड टू गो टू स्लीप. व्हेन ही वाज अबाउट टू स्लीप जस्ट एज ही वाज पुटिंग हिज हेड अंडर हिज विंग अ लार्ज ड्रॉप. यू नो द वे बर्ड्स स्लीप, दे जस्ट फ्लैप देयर विंग राउंड देयर फेस. Sometimes when they sleep, when he was about to flap his wing, and what happened? A large drop of water fell on him. What a curious thing. He cried, there is not a single cloud in the sky. The stars are quite clear and bright, and yet it is raining. Obviously, one will think that it is raining only, but when he saw sky is clear, stars are shining, and where did it come from? That large droplet of water. Then another drop fell upon the bird. What is the use of a statue if it cannot keep the rain off? Kata, I thought I will be sleeping in between the feet and I would be safe from the rain. And what is this now? I must look for a good chimney pot. And he determined to fly away. He thought I should find some chimney of a house and I should stay there. The moment he, started flying, what did he see? The eyes of the happy prince were filled with tears. That statue was crying. And tears were running down his golden cheeks. His face was so beautiful in the moonlight that the little swallow was filled with pity. Bird got pity for the statue. That why the statue is crying? Who are you? He said. I am the happy prince. Why are you weeping then? Asked the swallow bird. You have quite drenched me. Drenching means bhigo dena, barish ki wajah se ya pani ki wajah se. Bird said, you drenched me and why are you crying? When I was alive and had a human heart. He started narrating his story to the birds as if he was waiting that someone will notice me and I will narrate my story. That statue started telling his story. When I was alive and had a human heart, I did not know what tears were. Why he did not know what tears were? Because I lived in the palace where sorrow is not allowed to enter. Sorrow means dukkh. I was a prince. I was born to rich parents in a big province where my parents never allowed to enter any sorrow for me. My courtiers called me the happy prince, and happy indeed I was. He says, I was very happy. You know, I give you one example. We all are living in our houses. We are getting basic facilities. Sabko mil rahi hai. Fine, these days you're getting ACs, and during online teaching, you were so at rest. Fine, sitting at home, whether you're wearing your sleepwear or whatever, and you were so comfortable. And when we move out in the city, we see many beggars at the, signals. Sometimes we see people not having arms. Sometimes we see people not having proper clothing, shabby hair. You know, chote chote bachche signals pe pen bech rahe hain. And it's a pity to see that side. Sometimes we do help, but our help cannot change their life, at least. Some people just beg, but some people are putting in hard work. You might have seen these days many videos are being viraled and all about the hard work. So we'll continue this chapter because bell has gone. Okay, have a nice day.